win that one. Singapore have played a game less because of the group they were in the women's team. Comfortable against Vietnam, comfortable against Indonesia, and comfortable against Malaysia in the semi-final, the host nation. Three matches to love on all those occasions. Final will be a much different proposition though. Sutasini has a gold along with Padasak in the mixed doubles. She was also the gold medal winner in the women's singles in Singapore 2 years ago. So she'll be no pushover. Feng Tianwei, vastly experienced. Years of age now, Feng Tianwei, born in China. Moved to Singapore in 2007 under the Foreign Sports Talent Scheme. And immediately went into playing competitive table tennis the following month, and she's been a real star for Singapore over the term. She's played in two Olympic Games in Beijing and London. Gold in the World Championships in Moscow in 2010. Gold in the 2015 Asian Cup in Jaipur. And five Commonwealth gold medals to her name. Two in Delhi in the team and the singles. And three in Glasgow in 2014 in the team singles and doubles. So she knows all about winning, Feng Tianwei. Can she get Singapore off to a winning start in the final?
Women's team final match, Singapore.
We had the semi-finals for the men's and the women's a little earlier on, and you couldn't get a seat in the house. The full house sign was up outside the hall 7.
Singapore to serve, level.
So here we go. Singapore in the light blue. Feng Tianwei serving first. First to 11 in each game, of course. A couple of lets to start proceedings. Best of five games in each match. Been a good start for Thailand. Feng Tianwei just trying to ease her way into things.
One, three.
It was a titanic battle when these two met in the final in 2015. Singapore coming out winners by 3-2. No reason to think this one will be any less close. Feng Tianwei actually won her single. She was second out in that match, playing against Kechi Huan.
4-2.
Misses the edge of the table there, Feng Tianwei just chatting away to herself. Always difficult to lose the opening game in these matches. Thailand, who are extremely well supported, as you can see, their colourful fans are out in force once again.
7-3.
A little bit better from Feng. Service changes every 2 points, don't forget. So Suthasini back on serve.
7-4.
Suthasini edges a little bit further in front.
Set. 4-8.
Oh, good rally, best rally of the game so far. Just a little wide with that return. Suthasini. Feng keeping the ball very low over the net, making it difficult for Suthasini to try and conjure up a winner. Oh, good play again. Feng's finally finding her range a little bit now. Getting tremendous power in these shots.
Seven.
So we're back to within a point. And a good response. So game point then to Suthasini. And she takes the first game as well, 11-7, so work already to do for Singapore in the final. She's much higher world ranked. Feng Tianwei, currently ranked number 6 in the world. Suthasini at 57. Been a steady progression up the rankings for Feng Tianwei. She's got 5 players ahead of her and 4 of them are Chinese. Ding Ning, top of the table tennis world rankings. But it's Suthasini who's playing the more impressive table tennis in that opening game. A few words of encouragement for the coaching staff. She'll try and put it right in game 2, which is coming up in just a sec.
Second game. Suthasini from Thailand to serve. Love all.
Best of 5, don't forget, but Feng will want to try and get back into this one. She won't want to go 2 down and run the risk of not winning the final 3. Good start.
One.
That's better from Feng. She's starting to attack Suthasini on the serve a little more. Trying to be a little bit more aggressive. Realises she'll have to take the game to Thailand if she wants to get back into it, rather than the other way around. Another good winner. Three love. Been a great start. To the team there giving us some encouragement. Si Yihan, Lin Yi, Yu Meng Yu. Oh, getting right behind that teammate. First point she's dropped in this game. Good spin on the serve there from Suthasini. From the offset, she's on the offensive, Feng, which she wasn't in the opening game, and that's been the difference so far in this second game. Not sitting back, she's going for those forehand aggressive shots right from the start, and Suthasini's not quite sure how to deal with it now. Didn't have that in the first game. Feng Tianwei to serve, 6-1 up in this second match, second game rather. Oh, good winner. Better from Suthasini. So three more points needed for Singapore to level it up at one game all. Just long from Feng, who's really annoyed with herself. Need to try and cut out those unforced errors, especially against better quality opponents like Suthasini. And finding the vocal battle between the two sets of supporters quite amusing. That's good play from Feng. Seven game points then, two tied up at one game all. Much better. World number six living up to her billing. And she takes the game. Too much topspin on that for Suthasini to return. And 11-3. Very much morale-boosting victory in that game for Feng Tianwei, conceding just the 3 points to her Thai opponent. Now she just needs to do it twice more to give Singapore a one love lead in the match. You see the difference in the style from receiving and from taking serve, Feng Tianwei. She was very much on the front foot.
6-1.
Didn't see that from her in the first game. It was a little bit tentative from the Singaporean.
11-3, second game.
They've certainly added a little bit of glitz and a little bit of colour to proceedings, particularly here at the table tennis, the Thailand supporters. Mention those gold medals that Singapore have won, 40 of them, 33 silver, 33 silver, 43 bronze, 116 medals in total. Latest gold won by Jasmine Sir, who carried the flag for the opening ceremony a week ago in the shooting. So straight away, Feng's on the offensive in game three. One love, Singapore. Didn't help Feng then. Play again from Feng. Needed to get that winner then, because she was moving further and further back from the table, and that target becomes much smaller, of course, the further away you are. But she managed to win the point. Great technique. Feng to serve. And these sides met in 2015, or these teams rather met in 2015. One game went to the five games. Three matches went to four. Thailand eventually succumbing 3-2 as Singapore took gold, one of their six gold medals 2 years ago. Another winner. And she's celebrating every point, and rightly so at the moment. Sofocini's giving as good as she gets, but Feng just that little bit too good at the moment. Don't forget the men are in the final of the team competition a little bit later on as well. If they win both, Singapore would equal that six goal haul from 2 years ago. But overall, their medals would have increased. 10 medals in total in 2015. Whatever happens, they're going to get 12 medals here, even if they end up picking up two silvers, but they'll certainly hope to be going one better than that. Feng leads 6-2 then in the third game. To make sure no part of your body, whether throwing hand or anything else, touches the table, otherwise the point goes the other way. You saw Feng there coming into the table and just having to take evasive action at the end of the shot. Did win the point though. And just popped up again, the leg cord or the neck cord not helping. Winner again. It's amazing the speed that these players generate rule changes were made after the Sydney Olympics in 2000. The ball was made slightly bigger to slow the game down and make it more amenable for a TV audience. The bats have been slightly modified as well just to take some of the sting out of them, but it's still a tremendously fast game at times. Just a change of ball, so a quick knock up for the players to make sure they're happy. So Singapore serving then, 8-4 in game three, match one. There's that aggressive winner again from Feng. And it's game point once again to take a 2-1 lead, having fallen behind in the match. It's been a very good comeback. A little fortunate there, Sudhasini. Ball hit the net and dropped the right side. So she takes the point, still has serve, 5-10 down. Mini comeback from Sudhasini. So 3 points in a row won by Thailand. Still three game points though to Singapore.
Let 10-7.
And there is finally closes out the game. So
from Singapore,
Feng Tianwei takes the third game 11-7. Having lost the opening game, 7-11. Dominant in that second game when she was really aggressive, and that aggression continued into game three. 11-3, 11-7. And Singapore one game away from taking a 1-0 lead in the match as they go in search of a fifth gold medal in the table tennis. Look at some of the key moments from that game. No question, Sudhasini is a very good player, 23 years of age, the girl from Thailand. And currently ranked 57 in the world, 51 places lower than her opponent. But I'm sure she'll continue to rise the rankings as she gains that little bit more experience. It's all very good nature between the supporters. It's very musical as well. I'm surprised the coaches can make themselves heard at the moment. Anyway, we're ready for the fourth game of five. Sudhasini has to win this to take us to a decider.
First game, Sudhasini from Thailand to serve.
Sudhasini will have the first serve at level. Thank you. So having conceded the opening 2 points to Thailand, Singapore are on the board. Back to 2-2. That's a good return using the spin on Sudhasini's serve to make life difficult for the Thai to return. So Singapore lead for the first time in this fourth game. There's that aggression again on the front foot from Feng. So 5-2 down, Thailand calling a timeout. So Sudhasini just looks to have lost her way a little bit. She was so impressive in that opening game, but Feng has just lifted things over the last two and a bit games, and he's looking a totally different prospect she was from the start. Just needs to keep her composure, keep doing what she's doing, and Singapore will take the lead. So potentially 6 points away from a one love lead to Singapore. A good spin generated on that serve from Sudhasini. A couple of little errors just creeping into Feng's game at the moment. She'll be disappointed with that, having performed so well. Has got serve for the next couple. So Sudhasini trying to vary the shots around and get Feng thinking about her game, but that backhand's working really well for her, forcing the error from Sudhasini. Another brilliant forehand winner. That's been a great source of success for Feng throughout this game so far, that forehand. And she leads 8-4 now. Vassini on the comeback trail, back to within two. So Singapore's turn to call a timeout. She'd hope to have had this game closed out by now, but Savassini showing good resilience. Feng, a couple of errors in there that have cost her points. Her other teammates also giving her a few words of encouragement. Zhu Yuhan particularly. Well, let's see what the coaches have had to say and what sort of impact it has on their players. Now, Singapore still leading 8-7 with serve.
8-7.
And leading 2-1 in the match. They need to close out this game for a 3-1 win. Good winner, right on the white line down that side of the table. Great backhand from Savassini. Got the angled backhand going on at first, and then she played one straight down the line and catching Feng Tian way out. But it is match point Singapore. Two match points to go, one up in the five-match rubber. Little shake of the head from Savassini, disappointed to have hit the net. Feng Tianwei on serve. And there's the winner. So Singapore take the lead in the tie. A hard-fought encounter, as we expected. Feng Tianwei, the world number six, coming through against Savassini from Thailand. Savassini took the first game 11-7, but then three in a row for Feng Tianwei, 11-3, 11-7, 11-8, seals out the victory. A 3-1 win, and that sets Singapore up as they lead by one match to love in the best of five series. Look at some of the moments from that final game. It was a bit frustrating for both players. They both called timeouts. That was a particularly good winner from Savassini. But in the end, Feng proving too strong. And delighted to get through, despite the minimum emotion. So Yu Mengyu is up next. Yu Mengyu, the doubles partner of Feng Tianwei when they won gold in the women's. Taking on Tamil Wan from Thailand. So Fassini will be hoping her teammate can get the team back into the match. Very difficult. If you go two down in a five-match rubber, it takes a tremendous effort then to win three in a row. Flip of the coin before the players start to warm up. Yu Mengyu was part of the team that won the 2010 World Team Table Tennis Championships in Russia. Whole succession of medals. Three Commonwealth golds. She picked up two in Glasgow, again for the doubles and the team event. The team event in New Delhi. And seven Southeast Asian Games gold medals. The first of those coming back in 2009. When she won the team and the doubles. Singles winner in 2013. So Tamil Wan will have her work cut out. And hoping that Tamil Wan can get themselves back into this. So we're ready to go then in the second match. It'll be Tamil Wan from Thailand in the yellow serving first. Singapore leading by one match to love in the tie. Start this from Yu Mengyu. Just outside the world's top 100, Tamil Wan, 103. Four.
net.
That's been a good start by both players. Again, nothing much to choose between them. Very similar pattern to the opening match. Yu Mengyu will probably find Tamil Wan a tricky opponent, despite her superior world ranking, 33.
Ball five.
Singapore just edging ahead once again. We're getting towards the important part of the game now. Closing in on that 11 points needed. Thailand edge themselves in front. Good play by Tamil Wan. Just clipped the edge of the table. So back to 8-all. Not too much to choose between these two at the moment. Long that time from Tamil Wan, so back to 9-all. This could go beyond the 11 points. Has to be a margin of 2, don't forget, to win. Nine, But it is game point to Thailand. Tamil Wan has played exceptionally well in this opening game. Not fazed by a more experienced opponent. But we're back to 10-all. Yu showing all her experience there. Playing that one right into the body of the Thai player. And now it's game point, Singapore. And one save there by Thailand, so both players have saved the game point. Just too long for Yu Meng Yu, so again it's Thailand now with the game point. It's just too long, and Thailand take the opening game. So as they did in the first match, 13-11, the game goes to Tamil Wan. So once again, Thailand have got themselves in front in the match. Now they have to maintain that form over another two games to try and level the matchup at 1-1. They're delighted. Just about ready to go for game two. Sukhasini in the background there lost the opening game, so she'll be delighted that Tamil Wan has got off to a winning start.
Second game, help with the serve. Now out. One love. Love two.
Thailand's first point of this second game. Just wonder whether the coach would have been saying to Yu Meng Yu that you need to be aggressive like Feng was for those second, third and fourth games. Get on the front foot.
3-1.
just too long. Tamil Wat did the right thing, just trying to block those forehands back over and get them back into play, but the more height was on the ball, it was more appealing proposition for Yu Meng Yu to win or find the winner. The extra pace just saw that blocked return go a little bit long. So 4-2 Singapore lead. There's that aggression right from the serve. Turn.
Three, 7.
Singapore need 4 points to level it up at 1-1. That's a mistake on the serve from Tamil Wat. The ball just hitting the top of the net and flying away. So Yu Meng Yu goes a step closer to winning the second game. She's got two serves now. Good winner though from Tamil Wat. Coming up with the big shots when she needs to. Too long off the net. So 9-5, Thailand starting to close the gap. Just caught the top of the net and looped away. Just there, just took it long. So game point to Singapore. Tamil Wat's turn to flick the net and the ball going out of play.
Then 7.
One of them saved. Still three more game points. Oh, brilliant. Great forehand. It's another really good rally, albeit a short rally. The pace being generated on the ball. Great return there from Tamil Wat, and then spotting the winner out of the reach of Yu Meng-Yu. Back to 10-8, still game point though. So there it is, 11-8. Singapore take their first game of the second match. And we're levelled up at 1-1. And I just wonder whether this match will follow a similar pattern to the first. Yu Meng-Yu lost the first 13-11, won the second 11-8. But Tamawan has shown in flashes that she has got some very, very good shots in her armoury. Singapore are going to have to be at their best all the way through this tie if they're to take the gold medal.
So far. Three, 11-8. Game to Yu Meng-Yu.
And Tian Wei offering a little bit of advice there, having won her opening match. So they did win the women's doubles together, so I'm sure there's a little bit of mutual respect for the pair.
Players! Third game, Thailand to serve, Lawa. One love.
Just dropped over. Just seemed to almost hold itself on the net there before it dropped the right side in terms of Yu Meng-Yu getting the point. 3-1 she leads now. Good pace again from Yu. Causing the error from Tamawan. 5-2 now, Singapore lead.
Two,
need to cover some ground then. Good forehand winner. 14 the error from Tamil Wan once again. 7-3 then, Singapore lead. Very, very warm inside this venue.
Four, nine.
The heat turning up on Tamil Wan a little now. She's 9-4 down in this third game.
Ten, four.
So game point to Singapore for a 2-1 lead, having lost the opening game. And it's a match that is taking a similar pattern to the first. Yu Mengyu on serve.
11-4.
And she takes the game 11-4, so a comprehensive win that time for Yu Mengyu. Biggest margin of victory so far in the three matches, or three games. So confirmation, Thailand took the first 13-11, 11-8, 11-4 in favour of Singapore. As we were saying earlier, if Singapore could take gold in the women's and men's team event, it would be almost a clean sweep. The only one they didn't win at these games was the mixed doubles. Padasaka and Sudhasini beating Peng Zhuji and Yu Mengyu in the final of that one, but whatever happens, it's still been an impressive showing by Singapore.
What game? Singapore to serve. That one.
Yu Mengyu serving, then love all in the fourth game.
One love. 3.
Singapore drawing close. 3-2 now. Tamil making a good start. 20 years of age, Tamil one. So the first time Singapore have led in this fourth game. Thailand now on serve. Simple point one there by Singapore. Take the lead again as the serve switches back to them. For the backhand, sort of with a flick wrist there, Tamil one, but couldn't quite get around the ball, so it flies away at almost at right angles. And for that flick winner that's been quite productive for it during the match so far. Thailand have called a timeout.
Thailand.
And needing a few words of encouragement for her teammates here, Tamil Wan. Singapore again look as if they could be easing to another victory in four games. So Singapore leading 7-5. With serve.
7-5.
Good winner, Tamil one. Straight into the body of Yu Mingyu. No chance for her to get a bat on that one. So two more points needed for Singapore to take a two-love lead in the match. And a big lead it will be as well for them. Doubles up next. Tamil Wan won't give this up though.
10-6.
So four match points for Yu Mingyu for Singapore. And a step closer to another gold medal. So Singapore come through after surviving a scare in that opening game. Again, Yu Mingyu showing a superior world ranking quality over the 20-year-old Tamil Wan from Thailand. Tamil Wan did take the opening game 13-11. But then, similar pattern to the first match, Yu Mingyu took control, winning 11-8, 11-4, 11-6. Singapore win it 3-1 and take a two-love lead. And the maths is simple. Thailand have to win the doubles. Otherwise, the gold medal is going to Singapore. And that doubles will be on in just a moment's time.
That's the moment that I
So just about time for the doubles then. Tamalwan is coming out again for Thailand. It's Zhu Yihan and Yu Meng Yu for Singapore. Orawan Paranang is Tamalwan's partner. Orawan has played in most of the doubles for Thailand when she's been in the three-woman team. So Thailand have to win the doubles, otherwise the gold medal is going to Singapore. Quite interesting how it's changed this year. 2 years ago, Singapore were always chasing. They lost the opening singles, levelled it up through Fang Chen Wei. Paramang won her match, and Feng Chen Wei again before Yu Meng Yu sealed the victory. Mm-hmm. 3-2 win for Singapore on that occasion. They're 2 love up at the moment. Much higher ranked players. If you look at their world rankings, Singapore, Zhu Yihan is at 50 in the world, Yu Meng Yu at 33, Tamalwan, as we mentioned in the last game, 103, and Orawan down at 190. So Thailand to serve first. Can Singapore close out the gold with victory here?
Love, one.
That's a good start. Suyi Han was runner-up in the women's singles to Feng Tianwei. Singapore taking gold and silver. Yu Meng Yu, as we mentioned earlier, also got a single in that mixed doubles. Gold in the women's doubles with Feng Tianwei, so medals throughout this Singapore team. Thailand have just one gold and four bronze to show so far. Our guaranteed silver here, of course. Good run of points here for Singapore to take a slender lead in the first game. Just long that time, so back to 5-5. Angry point will be greeted with cheers and clapping from both teams. Quite strange looking around the hall now. There have been five tables in here all week. There's been action on all of them. Those tables have now disappeared. We're just left with the one TV table for the two finals. Not too many spare seats to be had in the grandstand as people come to see who's going to take the medals this afternoon. Men's final a little bit later on. And about 2.5 hours time from now. Singapore with a 2-point advantage then in this opening game of the doubles. That's a good winner from Tamil Wan. Singapore unable to return. So game point to Singapore. Tamil Wan couldn't get the return over that time. Focus on the face of Yu Meng Yu. And there it is. Opening game, 11-7. So for the first time in the match, Singapore actually take the first game. They've had to come from behind in the two singles. But Zhu and Yu have managed to get themselves in front against Tamil Wan and Ora Wan. 11-7. They're much higher ranked in the world, so that little bit more experience, that little bit more technique possibly than their opponents, but nevertheless, Thailand will give a good account of themselves.
Seven.
So can Thailand get themselves back into this one? Change of ends, of course, every game.
Second game.
Singapore to serve first. Good winner. Love. Zhu Yihan straight down the middle. Orawan's momentum had taken a one way, Tamawan's the other. It's a fairly straightforward winner. Oh. Net court and caught the edge of the table. So apologies from the Singapore players to their opponents, but Singapore now lead 4-love in this second game. It's very much going Singapore's way. Thailand yet to get off the mark in this second game. 6-love Singapore lead. Orawan to serve. Oh, lovely. Yu Meng Yu knew exactly what she was doing there, shifted her body round and just played that into the gap between the two Thai players once again. This is turning into a very one-sided game, to say the least. 9-love Singapore lead, second game.
One.
And finally, they are off the mark. Spiked by Yu Meng Yu. So 9 game points to Singapore to take a 2-love lead. So 11-2. Quick fire tie in that game. Singapore now just one game away from the gold medal. 4 gold medals already, don't forget, in the table tennis. Won both the singles titles, both the doubles titles. The only one they didn't win, managing to take silver in the mixed doubles. They also took the bronze in that as well, Clarence Chu and Zhu Yihan. Orawan and Tamawan really struggled in that game. Some lovely shots played by Singapore. Some well thought out shots rather than just going for pace and power. A couple of times Yu shifted her body round and just knew there was a gap between the two yellow shirts and played it into that gap to take the point. Oh. Well, they won't go down without a fight, Thailand. Their supporters have made plenty of noise. Can they add a little bit of respectability by taking this third game, or will Singapore close out the gold? We'll see in the next few moments. Orawan to serve. One thing they haven't done, Thailand, is managed to string a run of points together. That's what's been lacking. That's where Singapore have really done well.
5-1.
Timeout call by Thailand to try and give some encouragement to their team, but they really are being outclassed at the moment by Singapore. It's a very competent display by Zhu Yihan and Yu Meng Yu. Musical to the end, the Thai supporters. And a great source of enjoyment for the Malaysian crowd during this tournament. So we're back after the Thailand timeout.
5-1.
5-1 Singapore lead. Completely got that wrong. Well, this is a fantastic performance by Singapore's women. Doubles have been completely dominant. Rare point given away there by Zhu Yihan. Still they lead 9-2. So it is gold medal point to Singapore for their fifth gold medal of these 29th SEA Games. Tamil one to serve, and there is the winner. So Singapore take another gold, and their dominance of SEA Games table tennis continues. 11-2 in the final game, and it is Singapore's 42nd gold, which matches their best overseas tally that they got in Thailand in 2007. The men are in the final of the team competition a little later on as well. But confirmation of the doubles, 11-7, 11-2, 11-2. Singapore take gold. The singles matches before that, victories for Feng Shenwei and Yu Mengyu, both of those winning 3-1, having lost the opening game. But Singapore's medal haul at these games continues. They add the women's team title to the men's and women's singles, the men's and women's doubles. 5 golds, 5 silver and a bronze, 11 medals in total now. And as I say, one more still to play for when the men's team concludes a little bit later on this evening. Thailand decidedly second best on the day, but they take a silver medal as a consolation. A lot of their team are much younger than their Singapore opponents, and they'll go on, and who knows, in future SEA Games, could well be seeing them lifting or getting gold medals of their own. But this was all about Singapore, all about Singapore closing out another gold. The women's team have closed it with a 3-0 victory over Thailand, and they take the gold medal.
Smell like you. Every day discovering something brand new. I'm in love with your body.